Are you going to play that poker? It's like 20.
All right, Jack. So have you had a good day today?
That's it.
It's
been great.
What was the best part about today?
Well,
turned off the light to go.
Free fall.
That was good.
Yeah.
Now,
we're currently walking the streets of Florence after our meal.
Yep.
This building here is called Il Duomo.
Il Duomo.
I'm holding on your rope, got me 10 feet off the ground. And I'm hearing what you say, but I just can't make a sound. Tell me that you need me, then you go and cut me down. But wait, tell me that you're sorry, didn't think I'd turn around. Say
whoa, that's a guy playing that. Let's go see him.
That's good, let's go see
him. Yes, sir. Bark! Bark, bark! Bark, bark! Woof, woof!
Seven
now, going down to meet for
breakfast. James. Yeah, we'll
just sit down. Yeah.
Life is a movie producer,
it's
not easy, James. Are you just
about waiting
down until next half now? Yeah, we've got
nothing else to do.
Buongiorno.
Oh, too early?
Pat Nash here. We're walking the streets of Florence.
Hi. Hi, Pat. My friend's mum.
We're getting a tour right now by this lady. She knows a lot about Florence and can speak English. So yeah, we'll show you some of the things that we've come past. Bye-bye. Alright, behind me you can see this really big building.
What's it called, Pat?
I forgot what it's called, but it's a museum, and the courtyard was even used to like torture people when they were bad. Until it was illegal to torture people, then it turned into the museum as we see it today. That statue is behind of one of Michelangelo's statues. Yeah. That building that you just saw was the place where the Mona Lisa was actually painted. And yeah. Oh, and see these things? Those little hooks? That's where horses used to be, like, put onto.
Yo.
And yeah.
The Arno River. Okay. That river is the fourth longest river in Italy. And that river has provoked terrible floods through the ages. The last flood dates back to 1966. The 4th of November 1966, after many rainy days, the river overflowed its banks and the water submerged the city. And in some areas of Florence, the water reached 5 meters, 16 feet above the street level. Here you can see a plaque that recalls the level reached by the water in 1966. Can you see the white marble plaque with a blank line? That's the level reached by the water in 1966. You can see the date, 4th of November 1966. L'acqua d'Arno arrivò a questa altezza. That means the water of the Arno arrived here. So you can have an idea of the damages provoked to the city. All the city was flooded, okay, in 1966.
All right, we think Bud's pretty cool today. But you should see one of these medieval ones. It's crazy. See this window?
And here you can eat one of the best ice creams. Okay, it's very famous in Tivoli. So if you want to,
all they had to do was knock, and then they got served a bar of wine or beer. It's pretty cool.
Can you have taken a picture? What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more. Santa Croce Square, one of the most attractive squares of Florence. It took its name from the church you see at the end of the square, Santa Croce Church. Santa Croce means in Italian, what does it mean?
Holy Cross.
Holy Cross, yes. So it's dedicated to the cross of Jesus, the cross where Jesus was crucified. You can see the cross of Jesus at the top of the facade. You see the two angels holding the cross of Jesus. This church belongs to the Franciscan order. I know you're going to Assisi, so you'll see the basilica. The Franciscans, yes. Ah, okay. And so this belongs to the Franciscan order. Okay, so the Franciscans built this church beginning in 1294. I told you that most of the important buildings of the city were built in the 1200s. So also that church was built beginning in the 1200s. Its construction was completed 80 years later, at the end of the 14th century, even if the facade was left unfinished. This facade was left as a bare facade until the middle of the 19th century. Only in the 1850s they added this beautiful marble decoration. You see, there's nothing painted. There are three different types of marble. The white marble comes from Carrara. Carrara is a city to the north of Tuscany, you know. Now we are in Tuscany. Florence is the chief town of Tuscany. Tuscany is one of the 20 regions of Italy, okay? So to the north of Tuscany, there's this city, Carrara, which has these marble quarries, very famous throughout the world, okay? So the white marble comes from there. Also the marble used by Michelangelo and the other sculptures come from Carrara, from those quarries. The green marble comes from Prato. Prato is a city next to Florence. And the pink marble comes from Maremma, the southern part of Tuscany. So these are all local marble, which could be easily found in Florence. So you'll see them used also for other Florentine buildings, such as the cathedral, the Duomo, which is entirely covered with those marble. And at the top of the facade, there's a curious thing to notice. You see the blue star, which is the Star of David, symbol of the Jewish, which is rather unusual to see on the front of a Christian church. But the architect who designed the marble decoration in the 19th century was Jewish. That's why at the top he added that symbol with the symbol of the name of Jesus in the middle. You can see three letters, IHS, from the Latin name Jesus, Jesus. So in this way the architect underlined the Jewish origins of Jesus. And this church is very famous for its tombs. This is the church that houses the tomb of Michelangelo. Michelangelo was born in Caprese, a small town near Florence. He was born in 1475 and he spent most of his life here in Florence until 1534, when he decided to leave the city to go to Rome, where he died at the age of 89. He was rather old for that time. He died in 1564. And after his death, his body was moved back here to his native town. And he was buried in this church, as Michelangelo had lived in this area. And a few minutes I'll show you the house where Michelangelo spent his youth. This church also houses the tomb of Galileo Galilei, famous astronomer and mathematician who was born in Pisa. I know you went to Pisa, so you saw the native town of Galileo. He was born in 1564. He died here in Florence in 1642, so he was buried here. This church also houses the tomb of Gioacchino Rossini, one of the greatest composers and musicians of the 19th century.